that side of being a detective and a filmmaker at the same time began to appeal more and more to me. Whether I'm doing something that's a biography of someone where you're trying to understand how does this person take, who were they, why did they do this thing, whereas you're being a detective, a psychologist at the same time. It taught me also another big lesson of documentary making, which is that it's never just about you, the filmmakers, it's about the people you're making the film about. The funny thing is, when you're doing a fiction film and a documentary, when you're shooting them, they're very different experiences. But when you're in the cutting room, it's very similar, because you always think, oh my God, what a disaster. this isn't what I wanted, and that's the same in fiction and documentary. And then you need to learn to love your material, and you need to learn to listen to the material and say, what is this trying to tell me? What is the film that's in here? And you need to rewrite the film in the cutting room. Take a shot from somewhere else that wasn't meant for that and put it somewhere else without feeling like, oh, but that isn't meant to be there. You know, to be able to manipulate things to make the film work as well as it can. Without, you know, to kiss a documentary without lying, you need to be able to be creative. And my experience is that if people don't say no to you, if they say no, never, hang up the phone, then you're probably not going to persuade them. But 95% of people, they say, no, I don't really want to do it. And most people want to be persuaded. They want their stories to be told. But then what happens is that they tell you their story, and you see them in a particular way, and you understand their story in a particular way, but they see it in a different way, and they see themselves in a different way. So it can be quite shocking for people to see how the camera sees them and how they really come across. And some people can get really quite upset by that, I think, by the feeling that, but you know, I'm not that kind of person, but they're not seeing themselves. You know, it's an existential question, isn't it? I have a researcher or someone who does the contact with them and who talks to them and then meets them on the day when they come, and I stay away until 10 minutes before, and then I meet them, we say hello, chat a bit, try not to talk about what we're going to talk about, because I really believe that people will only tell their story well once. And there's a different, totally different energy. It's like a different performance, you know. There's a different energy the first time they say it to you, because they're trying to convince you, they're really reacting in a real, authentic way to you. And sometimes I have had to go back and do extra bits with people. And it's like doing reshoots on a fiction film. When you do reshoots on a fiction film, it never feels right. And when you do reshoots on a documentary, it's the same. You know, sometimes you get things that are useful. I needed them to talk about this area. Or sometimes I've even said, can you say something like this? When I'm editing a documentary, I'm trying to make it as much as possible like a fiction film. I'm trying to find the way to make it feel deliberate, as though everything in it was deliberately done and was meant to be exactly there, even though it wasn't, even though it came from chaos. So you're trying to make it feel as much as though it was meant to happen as possible. Whereas with a fiction film, I'm usually trying desperately to make it feel like a documentary, make it feel alive, make it feel spontaneous, make it feel like it's not a script which had three acts. And my brother is a film producer, and he was one of the executive producers on Last King of Scotland, and my brother produced a lot of films with Danny Boyle. And so I called up Danny Boyle and said, can I have a coffee with you? Can you tell me how to direct a film? And so I went to see him, and we spent 45 minutes, and he gave me the 10 key points of how to direct a movie. They were things like, don't be nice to your crew. They're not your friends. You've got to always push them to the absolute ultimate, because all they want to do is go home. And all you want to do is to get another shot. And then we talked about how to do a sex scene. I was very nervous because there's a very kind of erotic sex scene in the film. And I was very nervous about doing that. You know, the thing to do with a sex scene is just to make it so boring for the actors that they forget all about being embarrassed. So you have to rehearse it so many times. Put your right hand on her left breast, pull, and do it so many times that everybody's bored. So they were all good bits of advice.